So, here's the real question. How do dentists like you, who aren't willing to let insurance dictate how you will run your practice, who want to create incredibly profitable practices without sacrificing your time or sanity, how do you create the strategies to ensure your practice not only survives, but thrives in the 21st century? That's the blaring question. And Dr. Steve Schilinz is here to provide the answers. Welcome to Dental Practice Freedom Radio.
Hey, what's up, everybody? This is Dr. Steve Schilinz, and I want to welcome you back to another episode of Dental Practice Freedom Radio. And I have to admit, I'm in a hotel right now, and it's pretty early in the morning when I'm recording this episode. And I'm actually going to record two episodes. You might hear them later on. But so I'm just going to apologize in advance for not being as loud as I usually am. So you might have to turn your headphones up just a little bit. But I wanted to talk today about upgrading your software to be able to accomplish what it is you want to accomplish. And what does that actually mean? Well, one of my coaches, it was very interesting. I've been in the process, and we talked a lot about simplification two episodes, I think it was, ago. And one of the things that I did was basically started to convert all of what I did on my MacBook Pro versus my iMac. And what was interesting is, as I was learning this, one of the quotes that I heard, and it was so good, was, you can't run a major company on a freaking iPad. And I was thinking about that, and obviously freaking was a different word, but this is child appropriate. And I was thinking to myself, you know, that's so interesting. And it's interesting because from a business standpoint, it makes all the sense in the world. Like, I've actually tried to run my business on an iPad. I had the iPad is a little bit more mobile. I can write on it. I had an iPad Pro, and I had the Apple Pencil, and you can actually take notes on it just like you would take notes on any notebook, and I loved it. But the problem was, it was hard to do a lot of things. It was hard to bring it with me and update, you know, my funnels, to my traffic, my membership area, all that stuff. And the reason being is that the software of the iPad is just not robust enough yet to be able to do it efficiently and easily. And there's some lag time, and it wouldn't work as well. When you contrast that with a MacBook Pro, you know, obviously everything is just more efficient. It runs faster. Now, an iMac is even more efficient. The problem is it's not mobile. You can't take it with you. And so that creates an issue if you're traveling a lot, you know, like I do. You're not able to sit in front of your iMac. And that's a problem. But the reason I bring this up is not because, you know, I'm recommending Apple's. I don't care what computer you use. But the analogy here is that a lot of people that I've seen, if they're trying to build a certain type of practice or they're trying to build a certain type of business, they're actually operating with outdated software or a machine that's not going to get them where they want to go. And that machine is them. You have to understand that we all operate with a quote-unquote software-based program on a daily basis. It's called our self-image. It's called our belief system. And in order for you to be successful in your practice or your business, if you're not where you want to be, you have to realize that the software program that you're currently running is largely habitual-based learning. And in order for you to get a new result, either unconsciously you're going to change these things or consciously you're going to change these things and basically upgrade your software system. And so when dentists get consumed with this idea of, I need to build systems and policies in my practice, and I need to do this, and then I need to change this, and then I need to do this, just be aware that if you yourself have not upgraded the software system, you're now creating a hardware that still is operating on outdated software. So the business could be the hardware, right? And you get a new computer, you get a new practice, you get new systems, you get a new team, you get new policies, but like you still have to run it. And if your software isn't updated, you're still going to have issues. There's going to be glitches. I mean, this used to be a lot more prevalent back in the day, but think about this. Like if you have a brand new iPhone, but you're still running on an old software system for the iOS, there's all glitches and like things don't work. And you're like, why is this not happening? Or back in the day when you used to have like these old computers, you know, you'd have Windows 3.1 and then Windows 95 came out and nothing on these old computers would run on Windows 3.1. And you'd look at all the before apps and how computers run now. But like you used to look at all these games. I remember as a kid, I'd look at all these games and we had a certain computer and then we had a certain operating system. And the first thing you'd do is you find a game you really like. And then you looked at the requirements. What was the software necessary to run this game? And half the time, I couldn't buy the games I wanted because we didn't have the right software on the computer to run the game. Now, internally, I want you to be thinking about that. If you want to build a practice that does X, Y, and Z, or you want to build a life that does X, Y, and Z for you, what are the requirements from the software for you to get it? And then what do you do to change the software? Right? I just find so much as I study myself more and I study, you know, when I work with my clients and I study how they act and, you know, really some of the things that are holding them back. Nine times out of 10, it's this software issue. It's the belief system. It's the self-image. They are running an outdated software trying to get a different result and they can't do it. They literally don't have the bandwidth to produce the result that they want. So, hopefully you guys can see the connection because this is so freaking powerful. If you can understand the connection that in order for any practice to really run as successfully as it can run, it requires the owner of the business to be at peak condition, to understand themselves better than anybody else. Go study some of really successful business owners. Like the ones that really get it. Richard Branson to me is a great example. I mean, that guy just understands people. He understands business development. I don't think you'd ever, and I don't know him personally, but like just reading his books and studying his life, he's a risk taker. He's an adventurer, but he's also, he just understands himself. And it's so important in today's, and today, if you're going to go where you want to go in your business, like you have to spend time to study yourself. You have to spend time to understand who you are, what your belief systems are, what's holding you back from getting where you want to go, and start to upgrade your software first. And before you start to look externally, start to look internally. Spend a lot of time. I spend an hour a day on personal growth and development. Right? Like I'm always into personal growth and development and I got a long ways to go, believe me. But that hour a day, I would not change that for anything. I practice gratitude. I write down, you know, my goals. I listen to my goals. And then I'm deep into material that is helping me change my belief system because I know that even the software that I have right now internally is not going to help me get where I want to go with my goals. That's why I write goals. That's why I write goals that stretch me. And then I'm consistently working on improving the software to get, you know, the result that I want. So hopefully you got value out of this video. As always, if you like what you're hearing, leave a review, leave a rating. I'd love to talk to you about some of the stuff that I've been working on. If you feel like, hey, I think Steve could help me in this area, whether it's the software program or building a more wellness-oriented practice, there's some things that I'm working on. I'd be excited to share with you that if it's either of those components, I think it can really help you get where you want to go. So I encourage you guys to reach out to me. There's training on this in the link in the bio. But you also, I'm going to also give you a link to just schedule a call with me. I'd love to give the opportunity to talk to you, see what you need, see how I can best help you. And as always, have a great day, and I'll see you at the next episode.
Thank you so much for listening to this episode on Dental Practice Freedom Radio with Dr. Steve Schilintz. We'll see you on the next episode.